Hi everyone. Shapes Matching Game is a funny, educational activity for early learners. It teaches kids geometric concepts of shape, size, space, and position visually. The game is easy to play. Player's mission is to observe and recognize similar shapes. They need to drag the colored shapes to the corresponding dotted ones. If players drag incorrectly, the objects revert to their original positions and they get no point. In contrast, they will get 10 points once dragging correctly. In the end, they can complete a missing picture, then will be directed to the next one. Now, let's learn how to create a shapes matching game in ActivePresenter 8 through the following steps. Prepare resources and create the game's layout. Create the game. Preview and export the game. The very first step to creating any game is preparing resources. The shapes matching game requires some vivid background images and shapes. For background images, they can be pictures of a grassland or an ocean below a boat. Collect as much as you want. For shapes, they are available in the app. Navigate to the Insert tab. Click Shapes to choose what you need. The shapes matching game has 6 slides, divided into 3 parts. Introduction slide, content slides, and ending slide. You can add more content slides if needed. In the next step, let's create the game. The introduction slide in the game consists of 3 main parts: title, instruction, and the play button. Except for that, you can decorate to make it more eye-catching. Let's start with this part. Firstly, add a background image to the slide. To do that, in the Slide Properties tab, Background Fill section, select Image Fill. Then, click here and choose a background image. The decoration part has a moving square, circle, star, and triangle that flies to the corresponding target once. To add a shape into a slide, in the Insert tab, click Shapes. Next, copy, paste, and drag it to the desired position. Name them so that you can realize the drag source and drop target easier. Feel free to style them. Add entrance and exit effects to the objects. After that, add a motion path linking them. Change the direction of the path. Let's check how it looks. To make 3 more couples like that, simply group them, copy paste, and drag the group to the position you want. Next, ungroup, then, format and style the shapes. Then, name these objects. Align them to make the slide look better. After those shapes fly out, the title of the game appears. To do that, place the playhead at the time when all of these subjects disappear. Navigate to the Insert tab. Click here to add text. Typing the title, and style it. Add an entrance effect, and a motion path to the title as you did above. Then, come to Add Text to create the instruction, and customize freely. The last part of the introduction slide is the play button. To add a button, in the Insert tab, click here. You can change its font, size, color. Add entrance effect to the button. When players click this button, they will be redirected to the next slide to start playing the game. Therefore, you need to create an event, action for it. Click here to add the on-click event, then, select Go Forward. After all, reorder the objects, and adjust the start time of them, like being shown on the timeline. Note that, you should untick this checkbox, to prevent the slide from going forward automatically. Besides, set the exit effects of the title, instruction, and the button as none. Otherwise, they will disappear when the slide ends. Now, let's preview the introduction slide. The play button directs you to the content slides. There are four content slides in the game, let's create the first one. Set the background for the slide. Next, you need to create drag sources, drop areas, and a score box for each content slide. After that, take advantage of events, actions, to add interactivities to the game. In that way, each step will be described in turn. The first content slide asks players to match drag sources and drop areas to build a house. So, you need to use shapes to create some parts of the house. The first step, add the shapes to the slide. The house is built from four shapes: rectangle, triangle, hexagon, and rounded rectangle. They represent the body, roof, window, and door, respectively. Then, customize their appearance. Name them to identify each part of the house. Next, to convert these normal objects into drag sources, select them. In the drag and drop section of the Interactivity tab, select Drag Source. Then, the drag sources are bordered by the green dashed lines. Next, you can add drop areas from the Insert tab. There are four drag sources, so you need four drop areas. To do that, in the Insert tab, click Drop Area. Delete unnecessary parts, such as the default drag source, and feedback messages. Make three more copies of the drop area. Change the shapes of the drop areas, so that they have the similar look, with their corresponding drag sources above. At the same time, you can drag the objects to their appropriate positions on the house's parts. Name the drop areas as corresponding parts of the house. Style them the way you want. In the next step, you will specify the acceptable values and the correct values for those drop area objects. To do that, select a drop area. Then, in the drag and drop section, click here to open accept list. Accept values mean the drag sources that the drop area can accept. Meanwhile, correct values are the accurate answers, which help build a house correctly. So, tick the corresponding checkboxes in the accept and correct columns. In this game, you can set up a drop area to only accept one drag source as its correct value. As you can see, the orange arrow denotes that dropping a drag source into a drop area is a correct action. Repeating the step to the other drop areas. Besides, when players drag a drag source to a drop area correctly, its dotted lines will disappear. This state changing is easily made in ActivePresenter with the Object States feature. The normal state of the selected drop area is shown here. Click this button to enable the edit mode. Click here to add a new state. Select Drop Accept from the built-in states list. It shows how a drop area looks when any accepted drag source is dropped onto it. Customize its style to match with the drag source one. Then, click here to finish editing. Do the same way to the other drop areas. The shapes matching game will be more exciting if players can get points for each correct answer. Therefore, you should create a score box. Before that, you need to create a number variable. In the Home tab, select Variables. In the pop-up dialog, click here to add a new variable. Name the variable, for example, score. Then, choose number from the type list. Next, draw a shape to create a score box. Click to type text if you want, for example, type score. Then, feel free to customize it. Now, assign the number variable to the score box. Click to edit its inline text. Then, in the Home tab, click Reference. Select the variable that you have created. Finally, make the score box shown in multiple slides. By right-clicking it, selecting Show over multiple slides, top layer. The last step in creating the content slide is to create interactivity for the game. To do that, you need to add events actions to objects. According to the game guide above, if players drag correctly, the correct sound will be played. The drop areas are filled with solid colors, and you get 10 points. To achieve that, in the on correct event of each drop area, add the play audio action. Next, add the adjust variable action. Select score. The operator is at a value of 10. Then, add the hide object action. Select the drag source you want to hide. In that way, the drag sources disappear when dragging correctly. After that, add another play audio action. Select audio, for example, congrats. It is to prevent a slide from going forward too fast. In other words, the sound will be played when players complete a slide and get the maximum points. Therefore, You need a condition that the sound is only played when the score in this slide is 40. Finally, place the continue presentation action to the last, so that you can go forward to the next slide. Besides, when players drag incorrectly, the incorrect sound will be played. To do that, in the on incorrect event of the drop area, you can add the play audio action. Lastly, you can delete the unnecessary event in action. After all, the events, actions of a drop area will be like this. Now, you're able to do the same to the other drop areas. Keep in mind that copying actions from one object to another one saves your time and effort. Select the corresponding drag source of the drop area. Finally, you got the content slide like this. Repeat the steps to create the other content slides. The last part in creating the game is to create the ending slide. This slide is to announce that the game ends. You can add a background image. Then, add and style an ending message. Adjust its duration, add entrance and exit effects to the message. The last step to complete the creating game process is checking what you have built then publishing it. To check how the game works, click HTML5 preview or press F5 on the keyboard. To export the game, select one of these options. That's how to create the shapes matching game in ActivePresenter 8. Thanks for watching.